Lewis and Clark Public Health held a mass COVID-19 booster clinic Tuesday. MTN's Jordan Johnson spoke to officials about what this clinic means for residents.
Lewis and Clark Public Health held their first COVID-19 drive-through booster clinic on Tuesday, offering the shot to more than 1,000 people.
This is the first all-day clinic we've actually done. So where we were doing about 450 to 500 per day prior.
Brett Lloyd, emergency preparedness coordinator for Lewis and Clark Public Health, says that the drive-through clinic at Lewis and Clark Fairgrounds allows those who qualify to get the Pfizer booster.
It's an optional thing for people that want it, but the recommendation is that if you are in those high-risk groups, another dose is not going to hurt you. It's a good thing to have, help you build up some better immunity.
As the demand for the booster and vaccine shots ramp up, Lloyd says that public health is working to ensure the best process possible.
We are just trying to find a balance between the booster shots, the demand for the booster shots, and the availability of our volunteers and the availability of this facility.
For now, as the weather is still mild and the need for the booster is still high, Lloyd says that it is a great offering to the high-risk population.
And we have the facility and we have the team of experienced people to be able to do that for our community.
As a reminder, you will need to set up an appointment to receive the booster shot, and you can find those details on our website. In Helena, Jordan Johnson, MTN News.
Pfizer has submitted data about the COVID vaccine for younger children to the FDA. The agency will now conduct an initial review. However, Pfizer did not seek emergency use authorization for the shot in young children. Well, that is expected to come in the following weeks. The FDA will then meet with vaccine advisors who will need to make recommendations before it is able for children ages 5 to 11. Now, Pfizer will also likely seek approval from European Medicines Agency. Today, Montana reported another 1,200 new cases of COVID-19, putting the state at more than 11,400 active cases. 16 additional deaths have been reported, bringing the total number of coronavirus-related deaths to 1,989. Active COVID hospitalizations are also increased overnight and now sit at 427. 53% of Montana's eligible population is considered fully vaccinated.